pack here. We're going to get past the headlines, figure out what this could mean at home and abroad. Joining us now is Fran Townsend. She is CNN's national security analyst and a member of the CIA External Advisory Board. Morning, Fran. Always great to have you here on New Day. Let's talk about the news. Sure. Just came across the wires, an attack on a passenger train, the economy car, going from Lahore in Pakistan, like the cultural capital, to Karachi, the industrial capital. Is this relevant?
Well, we don't know yet, but for sure we know that Al-Qaeda has traditionally targeted transportation as one of their things. Remember the planes on 9/11. There's been the Madrid train bombing and bus bombings in London in the past. And so it's sort of, it feels like it may be related, but we're going to have to wait to get more out of the officials in Pakistan.
Now, we understand why you want to be careful about what you tell us about the knowledge of the threat so that the plan can't change. But we keep talking about abroad. We're going to go through it on the map here in just a second. But at home, is there any risk at home?
Well, we haven't heard. U.S. officials have not told us there's a threat at home. But, of course, they've briefed local police departments like the NYPD here in New York. They're on a high alert. And so I think what you're going to see, you may see a greater presence because police and law enforcement will be on the lookout here at home just in case.
Okay, so the intel we have so far really goes to it being abroad. All right?
That's right.
All right, so let's take a look. We're looking at the region here. You have Africa, you have the Middle East that we're looking at. Okay, so the first thing that we want to figure out is Al-Qaeda. That's what we believe the origin of the strength is. As we show where Al-Qaeda is strong, Al-Qaeda, organization or more of a brand now where people can just identify and affiliate randomly for the purpose of a single attack?
Well, more affiliates, but let's remember, here's Al-Qaeda, here's Yemen, and the threat is emanating out of Yemen. We've seen them go into North Africa. We've seen them throughout this region here in the Arabian Peninsula and here along the coast of Africa. And so what they do is you see Al-Qaeda in the Arabian Peninsula branching out and influencing. And just recently, Zawahiri issued a video statement naming his number as his operational chief, the guy who's the head of this unit, which is where the threat is emanating from, which is significant.
Now, Yemen is good because it's central for them. And also, as we'll remember, historically, the USS Cole, you know, what started precursor to 9/11 was right there.
That's
right
exactly
in the port of
Aden
coming in. So this has been a known locus for them. And that's why, as we target the embassies, give me that back, the embassies and consulates that we're looking to protect go in these areas of strength as well, right?
That's right. Exactly
and
right.
We're not hiding it from you. Here, we'll give it to you, the names. All right, and so explain why this is where we're looking at these 19 or so embassies and consulates.
Sure. Well, because, as I mentioned, you've got Yemen, right? And this is where they're centered from. We've also, by the way, Chris, seen increased drone strikes in Yemen against targets. You got to assume that's, again, also related because what they're doing is trying to disrupt this plot. That explains why you close these embassies throughout the sphere of Al-Qaeda influence.
Gotcha.
So that what you do is take targets away and you buy operational time to try and disrupt it or capture those who are most responsible.
And that's good. That allows us to end on the biggest question. That when we see what is defensive action, is that a function of what we know or what we don't know? You know, why are we being just defensive, not offensive?
Well, you got to presume we are being offensive. You just don't see it, and they don't talk about it because they are trying to capture these people, disrupt the operation. Look, they're doing exactly the right thing. All these things are dots. So it's the Zawahiri video. It's the appointment of the number two. It's the drone strikes. It's the intelligence that they've gathered. All those things are the kinds of dots pre-9/11 we didn't put together that they're putting together and taking defensive action.
And at the same time that we hear about this, there's offensive things going on as well to remove the threat.
Absolutely.
Fran Townsend, thank you very much.
Great
as
to be
always.
With you.